In the last lecture, we have discussed what is error and types of error, what is the meaning of error detection, and also we have discussed simple parity bit checking and two-dimensional parity bit checking to detect the error at the receiving end. Now, in this lecture, we are going to introduce another error detection technique called checksum. The checksum is used in the internet by several protocols, although not at the data link layer. Still, it is one of the important error detection techniques. The concept of the checksum is not very difficult. Suppose our data is a list of 4-bit numbers that we want to send to the destination. In addition to these 4-bit 5 numbers, we are going to send the summation of the 5 numbers to the destination as well. For example, let us consider we have 5 numbers 5, 9, 14, 2 and 11. These are the 5. Each of the numbers can be represented using 4-bit. Now, in addition to these 5 numbers, we are going to send the summation of these 5 numbers. That is, if we sum up all these 5 numbers, the value will be 41. So we are going to send these 6 numbers to the receiver. And at the receiving end, receiver will sum up the first 5 numbers and compare with the last number. If both are same, then receiver will accept and discard the last one, that is the summation part. Now, to reduce the job or make the receiver job little bit easier, we can send the negative of the summation, such that at the receiving end, receiver can add all the 6 numbers, and if the summation value is 0, in that case, receiver will assume there is no error, and receiver will accept the first 5 numbers and discard the 6 number, that is the checksum numbers. Now, consider one example to understand how checksum algorithm works. Consider sender needs to send a packet of data or frame of data containing 32 bits, and sender and receiver are agreed to work using checksum error detection technique with 8-bit checksum. So here the total data frame size is, or data unit size is 32 bit and the checksum is 8 bit. Now we will see the step-by-step procedures to implement the checksum error detection technique. Step 1, the given data unit will divide it into 4 segments with 8 bit each of the segments. So here we divide the 32 bit data unit into 4 8 bit segments, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Next, step 2. In step 2, now all the segments are added and the result is obtained, and the resultant value also should be in 8 bit. Now, for adding all the segments, we will go step by step. First of all, we will add segment 1 plus segment 2 and find out the partial sum. Now, since here the partial sum is a 9 bit value, we will wrap up the leftmost bit and add it with the right 8-most bit and find out the partial sum. Now the partial sum is a 8 bit value. In the same way, we are going to add the segment 3 with the existing partial sum and find out the next partial sum value. This is a 8 bit value, so we do not need to do anything. This is a 8 bit value, so we do not need to do anything. Now we add segment 4. After adding segment 4 with the current partial sum value, it will be again 9 bit value. Now again, we will wrap up the leftmost bit and add it with the rightmost 8 bit and find out the summation value. So this is the ultimate summation value with 8 bit. Now after getting this summation value, we will convert this summation value into negative value. To doing or finding the negative value, we use 1's complement arithmetic. In 1's complement arithmetic, we find out the 1's complement value just flipping each bit in the data word. So here we got the 1's complement value by flipping each bit. For example, 0 to 1, again this is 0 to 1, 1 to 0. In this way we get the 1's complement value. So this is our checksum value. So in next step, that is step number 3, what we will do, we will add the checksum with the existing data unit and send that whole data unit with the checksum data to the receiver. Now at the receiving end, the received data unit is divided into segments of 8 bits again. All the segments along with the checksum value are added. So what happened? If there is no error, in that case, we will find out the sum of the segments again, and the resultant value will be the same what we got at the sender side, that is 001 001 01. So the same sum we will get at the receiving end if there is no error occurred in the data words. Now again, if we add the sum and the checksum bit what receiver received from the sender, in that case the resultant value will be all ones. Now again, if we make the ones complement, that will be all zero. Since the result is zero, the receiver assumes no error occurred in the data and therefore accept the data units and drop the checksum value. This is the procedure to detect the error using the checksum. Now consider if any error occurred, in that case this sum will not be the same as we get at the sender side. It will be different. Let's say at the receiving end, while we break down all the data unit into segments, the sum what we get from the first four segments, let's say that is not the same as we get at the sender side. Let's say that is 01 1 0 0 1 0 1. So this is not same as the sum we get at the sender side. Here this is 0 and in this sum this is 1. Now if we add the checksum bits with this sum of value 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 0, the resultant value will be 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 0, carry 1, so it will 1 0. Now again, if we wrap up this leftmost 1 and add it with the rightmost 8 bit, the resultant value will be, so this will be the resultant value. And if we make the 1's complement, it will be, so this is the 1's complement. So this is not 0. In that case, receiver will assume there is some error, so that's why it will not accept the data units. It will reject all the data units and ask the sender to resend the same data units again. This is the procedure how checksum works. In the next lecture, we will going to discuss another very important error detection techniques. Thank you.